Well, speaking of women's fighting, what in God's name happened with Nia and Charlotte?
I thought the almost match was worse. Although they were both, there were two terrible matches in a row.
The almost match was worse because almost is green. But like Nia and Charlotte just, they started fighting. Like,
they weren't fighting.
What in God's name happened in that match?
The way I don't know. It was just a mess. It was terrible. I've heard people say that they were trying to work a shoot, and that's why it looked so terrible. But whatever.
Well, they certainly succeeded in making it look terrible.
Yeah, I mean, it just whatever. It was a really bad. It was two really bad matches in a row. You know, both of those matches. You know, but the Charlotte. I mean, you know, the whole thing. It's like, you know, Nia looked bad in that match. I mean, they both did, but Nia looked really bad in that match. And it's like now she's. I guess this is the new program for Extreme Rules. I mean, that's the one that they picked. And you know, whatever. You know, I mean. I guess they figured that, you know, Nikki's not over, and Ripley, I guess they don't want to go with just yet. So, and maybe they'll go with the three-way and put Ripley in later. I don't know. But, you know, Nia beat Charlotte clean. So, in normal thought, which, you know, it's very dangerous when you try to think normal when you watch a WWE show. But in normal thought, that would seem to set up a pay-per-view match for the championship, which from this match... The one thing I'll say is that if they have
Who
a rematch...
Who could possibly want to see the rematch of this one?
Not I, but it will probably be a better match than this one. I think that's safe to say. But I don't. That's not saying they're going to have a good match because I don't know. I mean, the other thing, too, is that match was even on at their best, Nia in a long singles match is never a good idea. I mean, the match was laid out to be too long to begin with, but yeah, it just whatever it was, it looked like it completely fell apart and was a mess, and that it looked like they were fighting each other, which is undoubtedly what they were trying to show, but I don't think that it was a positive at all. You know, the attempt to make it. Because it is clear that they did attempt to make it look like a shoot, you know, and sloppiness is part of a shoot, but...
But here's the problem with the idea that they were trying to make it look like a shoot. Nia at one point lifted her up and just dropped her. I mean, just carelessly dropped her on the back of her head. And, there were a few spots in this match, and Nia was also careless in the Rhea Ripley match. And then she goes for a leg drop and misses, and Charlotte boots her. And then Charlotte's trying to go for a cover, and Nia just stands up. And at that point, Charlotte slapped her, Nia shoved her. They kind of
were working for submissions.
They were now it was before that. Like first, they start shoving each other, and then Nia grabs her by the hair and starts punching her in the face. They end up in the ropes. Nia goes to lift her.
She wasn't really punching her though.
She had two shots that were hard shots.
They weren't all out shots. If she had hit her with all out shots, it would have been a disaster. That didn't happen.
It was a disaster.
Yeah, but it wasn't real shots.
So then she goes to lift her, and Charlotte won't go up. Then Charlotte hits the ropes, and Nia just stands there, and Charlotte jumps up on her shoulders. It's like, how is this working a shoot? You just worked a shitty match if that was your plan. I mean, literally, she starts running, and Nia stands there, and Charlotte jumps up and... I mean,
She tried a guillotine, and the other one wouldn't go for it. It was ridiculous. It was terrible. What can you say? It was terrible, terrible wrestling.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.